Following video is rated M for strong language and idiotic mistakes. May contain spoilers with attitude. You have been
warned. Hey guys and gals, James here, aka Way Demon Guinness, and on Gaming Theater, we are checking out the Perils of Man. This is a game on Steam for $9.99 or your regional equivalent. Publisher Vertigo Games and If Games were kind enough to give me access to this game, so we are going to check out this indie adventure game. So let's check it out. Now, originally,
the mysterious, the curious, the blurriest.
From the aesthetic time, is what
man
got
has
me.
Wondered about mysteries. Are they fiction or are they fact? The Eberling Enigma. Submitted for your examination, Eberling. A name synonymous with innovation. A name on which fortunes were made through startling, prolific inventions. A name known also to disappear. Thomas Eberling was at the height of his brilliant career, and some said working on his most ingenious invention yet, when he suddenly disappeared from public life forever, more than 150 years ago. But what happened to Thomas? Was he the victim of foul play by a jealous rival? Or had he stumbled upon something so powerful that it had to be kept hidden?
A little bit of both.
Thomas's genius was inherited by the latest Eberling, Max Eberling, a virtual rock star in the up-and-coming scientific community. Unfortunately, genius was not the only thing these two men had in common. So too were their penchants for disappearing. But why did he vanish too? Max was last seen 10 years ago at this infamous Einstein Awards banquet, where hundreds of the world's top minds were saved when a fire alarm cleared the room just moments before the ceiling collapsed. But when the ceiling collapsed, Max, like a rock star, had left the building. How could a man, even a genius such as Max, have predicted such an event? Yet this footage clearly suggests that Max Eberling did just that. Why would a man admired by all and a hero to many walk away from his newfound fame? Surely the key to this mystery is more than the simple wish to avoid the notorious scientific paparazzi. What are the secrets being held by the Eberling estate? Did the Eberling genius come with a price? The price of a curse? The world may never know, but that won't stop us from wondering whatever became of this modern mystery.
What I really want to know, Dad, is why you're wearing sunglasses everywhere except where you need them most.
Wait, something about the shades?
I thought I heard your father's voice.
I don't think so. You're imagining your ghosts again.
No, I'm certain I heard him, Anna. As clear as if he were standing right here. Have you felt a shiver coming over you,
Mum? Why did Dad wear sunglasses all the time?
Well, why don't you just ask him? He's probably in your bathroom. Sometimes he likes to go...
No, Mum.
She must be insane.
Was that mystery show. I was watching it again.
This is how you want to spend your birthday.
No, listen. I think I found something interesting this time. You see, it's the sunglasses.
I think you're going to find this much more interesting.
What's this?
I found it a few weeks ago in an old shoebox.
It's like Tim Burton mixes with Psychonauts style, like,
has this been hidden
arts.
In the house all this time?
Either that or one of the ghosts left it.
This looks great!
What is it? What does this mean?
Maybe it's a way to contact your father on the other side.
Okay, so she actually believes in ghosts. Okay, never mind. So she's not entirely insane.
I know it's been 10 years, but I always had the feeling
he was still alive. Would I be seeing his ghost everywhere? Would I?
No, but maybe he's stuck or trapped somewhere or held captive by someone.
Maybe he's helping Tintin find Professor Calculus.
Seriously, Mum? You really don't know anything about his work?
Never you mind, never you mind. It's best left alone. For your own good. And so on and so on. That is what Max always said to me. And that is what I say to you, my sweet. Now, I ordered in some nice birthday cake, and I suddenly feel a nasty draft coming from somewhere. Whew. Are you coming down?
But what if these things are clues that will help me find him?
It's best left alone.
Okay, I hate to say this, the voice actress for the mom doesn't match up with the way she looks. I kind of expect like a snooty, heavyset woman? Like older woman in maybe like her 80s with like the monocular, like the binoculars that have a golden bar, and she'd be like, alone! Sorry. Alright, let's look around here. School stuff. Funny thing is the game actually didn't tell me how to do anything, so I'm assuming when it wibbles and wobbles, that's...
I should take Mom's boots. She'll probably ask for them later.
Okay. What's a guitar gonna be?
I once posted a video of me playing Seven Nation Army. Nobody watched it, thank God.
So why did you post
it? At least we've got plumbing. That's the only improvement they've done in 150 years.
Trust me, plumbing is way more important than you think.
I don't know why I even need a mirror. I almost never get to go out.
So she's a shut-in. Okay.
I've read all the books on it.
Okay.
Chemistry notes. Mum won't let me do any of the lab experiments. She says somebody might blow something up.
Yeah, probably. Well, if you are the daughter of a genius.
Stuff that looks gross on me. I wasn't made for this century.
Is that Breaking Bad in the background? That probably is.
Stuff I've outgrown.
Okay, I guess the only thing we had to grab was our boots. Nice scene transition. Again, awesome, looks cool, looks badass. Don't want to go upstairs though.
The storm knocked out our phones.
And the dead will surely come.
The old family cuckoo clock still works perfectly. As long as someone remembers to wind it. Odd. My house keys are missing. I'll bet Mom knows where they are. I'm not vacuuming on my birthday. The only time you took off your sunglasses, and the sun was in your eyes.
Okay, I guess maybe that is a little strange. Maybe. Oh, dead light bulb.
Sigh. No one's going to fix this except me. It's an old mechanical diorama. My mother always said it was a family heirloom too delicate for kids to play with. But now I wonder if it has something to do with my father's disappearance. This diorama never worked before, but I'll use my birthday wish. Looks like negative and positive wires. It looks like a tiny speaker. There was probably something attached to amplify sound at one time.
Okay. Well, we don't have anything yet that'll be able to do that. I connect the wires.
In here.
And I would want to do that. Why?
Just bits and bobs. And a light bulb. The fireplace must be crazy hot now. I don't like putting it up that high. It's dangerous.
That's okay. Don't worry. It'll be okay. I promise.
Sigh. It's my job to maintain the lights in the Mother's been hoarding in. Mother's been hoarding incandescent bulbs. Perfect fit.
Okay, what did that?
I vaguely remember my father fiddling with this before he went away. It might have some connection to the glass vial. Or not.
Okay, so we have light on it.
Mum must have locked the door.
That's weird. Right? I mean, is that normal for her?
No,
it's too hot. Would you turn it down?
I know what they are. Socks. Mother doesn't like lit candles. They lead to house fires. Cards from Mother and some relatives. My friends don't send cards. They'd never get past my mother.
Okay, so she's a shut-in. She probably has school friends, but she can't go out. Why? You know what? Wow, there is a lot of things to talk about. Wow! Have a question? Yep.
I see the fuse blew in the gallery again.
Maybe rats chewed the wires, but I didn't want to call the electricians. They might fall off a ladder or burn the house down. Better off left alone.
But isn't it good to look at all the family portraits in there once in a while?
Best stay out of there. I only use it for storage now. You might trip on something and kill yourself.
People don't kill themselves tripping on things.
That's where you're wrong, Anna. It happens all the time.
Maybe those portraits can give me some clues that will help me.
Okay, little surprise. Anna herself, her like, animated one on the lower left, really high res, good AA. Mom, not so much. It's a little pixelated. I wonder why.
It's too risky to go in.
Wait.
Here's a flashlight and a 15 amp fuse.
Okay. So...
our dead flashlight.
I need a Okay, so I need a... Aha! That does not work. That does not work. Alright. I like that, though. That is kind of cool. And I can't see any of this because it's too dark.
The fire's too high. It'll burn the house down.
Mother, don't you know that's what I want to do? The house must burn, Mother. Must burn.
I need to fix this old thing.
Can I? Oh, wrong button.
I need to fix this old thing.
All right, let me try. This feels weird. Oh, maybe I screwed that up. Hang on.
That doesn't need a fuse.
Well, you know, sometimes an idea is an idea. That's a wrong idea.
The thermostat's in here.
Okay.
The fireplace should be low now. Mum will be unhappy.
So either damned if we do, damned if we don't.
My key should be hanging by my purse. My keys are usually right here.
Let's go ask Mom where my keys are. That does not sound like the fire is low. Oh, no, it is.
It's burning low.
Hmm.
Hey.
Let's see. Keys. Looking for the keys.
Was there some reason why you locked the front door and took my house keys?
I'm sorry, Anna, but I was afraid you'd go out into the storm and get hit by lightning.
What are the odds of that?
Zero, as long as you stay in the house.
Yeah, no, Mom's basically insane. She's also very paranoid. I mean... yes, her husband probably went disappeared in some weird way, and so she's probably thinking, I'm gonna protect my daughter any way I see fit. But, you know.
Why do we keep blowing fuses?
Spirits disrupt the flow of energy.
I feel like something is drawing power that we don't know about. We need a generator. We can't let every storm knock out our electricity.
Oh. And leave cans of explosive fuel lying around in storage?
Let me outside to see the storm.
I can't. You know the rules. We battened down the hatches in the storm.
Did you ever think of selling this old house?
Never. Where would all the ancestors live?
Honestly, I really like this house so far. This
Where
is an awesome house.
Experiments?
He went to the Institute. He locked himself in the study.
But when he was here, did he have a lab?
And she goes completely quiet.
What do you and Dad's ghost talk about?
I tell him how you're doing.
It's okay, Mum. I'm glad.
He's very proud of you.
What about visiting your family?
I feel really bad for the mom.
Don't you miss all those society parties?
Your father was always the most interesting person in the room. Not really.
I'm totally digging this. The reason is they give you a lot of exposition, a lot of narrative background that you can choose to, at your own pace, find
Why did
out.
You close the shutters behind you.
This is
Lightning
really
might
good.
Break the window.
Are you still getting chills?
I always feel a draft when ghosts are active in the house. I'm too cold to sleep.
Okay, now let's see. Diorama, here we go.
Do you know how to make the diorama work?
Stay away from it, Anna. They use it to get into the house.
It's just the old place creaking, Mum.
If it were just the house settling, then why are my feet cold? So cold. The house is not settling. It's possessed.
Cold feet. That's my mother. If she were in a sauna, and the sauna was in the Sahara, and the Sahara was in full summer, what would she have? Cold feet. Still, she might be right about that diorama being connected to my ancestors. Somehow.
Shouldn't she get rid of it? I mean, she feels like it's a threat.
Did Dad ever get the diorama to work?
Yes. Long ago. But he said it had a ghost. Pepper's ghost.
Pepper? Who's Pepper?
What's that old diorama do, Mum?
It's an automaton built by your great-great-great-grandfather, Thomas Eberling. I've never seen it work, Anna, but don't touch it. Your father always said it was haunted by Pepper's ghost.
And there's the question,
Who
okay.
Who is Pepper?
I think he was an inventor friend of Thomas's. But it's not only Pepper's ghost. It's the ghost of all your ancestors.
Do you know why Thomas built the diorama?
Your father never said. But he always smiled when he looked at it. Like it was some sort of private joke. And no one was allowed to touch it.
We are so going to touch it.
Tell me again, who built the diorama?
Oh, you know, darling. That crazy old... Thomas, your great-great-great-grandfather.
Great. Great-great.
Do you have a theory about this glass vial?
No, but I'm sure you'll figure it out. You think just like him.
What do you think really happened to Dad?
Ask his ghost.
Why did he always wear sunglasses?
He said he injured his eyes in a lab experiment. I never believed him.
So after they had that family portrait, the lab accident must have occurred and left him wearing glasses?
How come I never got a pet for my birthday?
I thought the bird in your cuckoo clock was your pet. Anyway, animals don't like ghosts.
Well, she's got a point about that one.
Now that I'm 16, how about a drink?
Heavens no, too dangerous.
How much trouble can I get into here?
She's got a point.
Can we go somewhere to celebrate?
And drive on these roads in a storm?
Alright, so I got something in What?
Something Mother said about the diorama. Who was Pepper, and how did he or she die? It looks stale. It's been out too long. I don't have the stomach for it. She gives me socks every year. She makes me blow out unlit candles on my birthday, and it drives me mad.
Okay, let's see.
I need to fix this old thing.
Can I...
Something Mother said about the diorama. Who was Peppa, and how did he or she die? Won't fit. Don't see what that'll do. This diorama never worked before. But I'll use my birthday wish. Something's supposed to be between these wires.
I feel like a fuse would be a good idea, but apparently not.
I'm so glad that didn't work, because if that did, I'd be really concerned about-
I really need to save our last fuse for our fuse box.
Oh, I would be really concerned how to fix and solve the puzzles in this game. Alright, is there any way to... Okay, so I can only go left or right, which is great. That limits my functionality, gives me a better idea what I can do and what I can't do. So, maybe there's something upstairs that we forgot. I can only go into my room, right? Right. No, 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 no. Oh, don't want to do that. I'm sorry. Okay, can we go back? Please? 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 Okay. So we can't go to the right. And it's because it's too dark, so we need batteries. We need to fix the diorama. There's got to be something we are missing.
Nothing in there I need.
Ooh, bee bunny.
Bunsen bunny! I always played emergency vet with him and father. Dad had... We always have to swap batteries in this house.
Aha!
Done.
I really like this right here. I cannot stress that. It's so cool. It's simple, but it's simple, but great. And that is important. Especially in an adventure game. Because if you have too many commands, you're just like, alright, do I push, pull, tuck, suck, blow, talk, discuss, take, grab, drop? Alright, so we should be good going in here looking at the photos. Alright. Yeah, what is in this? None. This is not creepy at all. Okay. Can I go in the creepy doorway here? No? That's a fuse box.
We need to put in a new fuse. 20 amps or less. Please don't blow up in my face.
Good. Yes!
I won't need the flashlight anymore.
Okay, did I get rid of the flashlight? I did! Okay.
Now, nothing's more important than working late with you guys. I love work so much. I put my famous career above everything else.
Oh. Bitter? Not at all.
That lampshade's getting burned by the bulb.
What the hell would you use a lampshade for?
Leave it. I never liked it.
Alright, is there anything... Ah! Stuffed elk.
Wonder which Eberling shot that beautiful creature. I suppose he would be dead by now anyway. Didn't we have a ladder here? What happened to it? This clock has never worked. I think it's someone's idea of a joke.
Alright, is there any way I can... Nope, okay. Last family
photo. That was my best memory as a kid, but now all I can think is... Were you already planning to leave us?
That's if your father was, you know, wanting to leave.
We got copies of almost every newspaper in Switzerland when father disappeared. But we never found a clue about where he'd gone. Mansions and novels never have leaky roofs. Not so exciting when it's next to a motorbike. Max Eberling. 1968 to... So, this is my father, Max. I don't remember much about him, really. I was only 6 the last time I saw him. Again, scientist. And, again, nobody seemed to know what he was working on. I don't know what it is with this family and mystery projects. Victor Eberling, 1936 to 1998. The story on Conrad's son, Victor, is that he ruffled the family feathers when he threw away a promising career as a surgeon for a life at sea. Officially, he crossed the world as captain of trading vessels of questionable origins while documenting the diffusion of infectious diseases. Which sounds like the Eberling way of saying he was a smuggler. If there was ever any proof one way or the other, it was lost at sea when his ship and everyone on it went down in a heavy storm. Was it the Eberling family curse?
So if you're a man and you're Eberling, you are more likely to disappear before you actually have a chance to die.
The reason Mum won't fix the roof? She's worried the roofers will get hurt. Avoid that. I took everything I need. My favorite ancestor is Thomas Eberling, my great-great-great-grandfather. He was also a pretty great scientist and inventor. Something about this portrait looks new. My great-times-three grandfather. Something's odd about that painting. Purple checked coat, blue striped bird. I don't think so. Green book with circles, red rose. Strange details.
Yeah, kind of.
Edgar Eberling. 1847 to 1892. Edgar was a scientist like Thomas, but according to Mom, he wasn't as brilliant. He spent most of his life traveling the world, probably to get away from the expectations of his famous father. He did a good job of it too, because no one even knew where he was for years. Then all of a sudden he came back and started giving public lectures warning about the dangers of gas lighting. Which is odd because he died in a theater fire. He also had a reputation as a ladies' man but never married. How's that for colorful?
Okay, is it me or you either die in a very tragic and dangerous way or you just disappear?
Conrad Eberling, 1878 to 1941. Conrad showed up after Edgar's death. Some people wondered if he was really Edgar's son, but he had the Eberling inventor gene sure enough. He designed and piloted early airships, which is pretty cool. But the big thing he was working on was the first aerial map of the whole planet. It was supposedly the most detailed map ever made, but I've never seen it. No one has. I need to fix this old thing.
Alright, so... you know, I wonder... Nope, okay. Electrical wires, switch, speaker.
I'm pretty sure audio comes out here, but it needs something to boost the volume.
A lampshade, maybe?
It fits perfectly.
Okay, that'll work. And... Oh, wow.
Understanding of what I have discovered, this must be held in absolute secrecy. Should you have any doubts along the way, Darwin will assist you.
Is that a hologram?
I congratulate you on discovering the secret of Pepper's ghost. My name is Thomas Eberling, and I designed this automaton to test your intellect and strength of purpose. But this is only the first test. My years of private research have resulted in a momentous discovery. I have harnessed a power which may prove to be of immense benefit to mankind, but which also holds the potential for unprecedented destruction. After witnessing this destruction in my own
She's just like completely shocked.
I had
just like, oh my god.
Mankind was not yet ready to possess it.
Yep, there it is.
For this reason, this is your laboratory to continue my work in secrecy. However, as dangerous as this power can be, I could not in good conscience permit its virtues to be lost to humanity. It became necessary for me to make provisions for my eventual demise. The secure area can only be accessed from my study. To gain entry, you will need to count the specific hours of the day, beginning with the zero hour. And the code to those hours is in this book.
Yep, this is a hologram. Holy
Remember
crap.
This book and the starting point, the zero hour. A word of warning. You are about to embark on a perilous journey. Until you have come to a full understanding of what I have discovered, this must be held in absolute secrecy. Should you have any doubts along the way, Darwin will assist you.
Okay. Did you ever have one of those moments where your entire life just got completely thrown out the window in a moving car? Yep, that would be this girl. Alright guys, this has been The Perils of Man. You can get it on Steam right now for $9.99 or your regional equivalent. If you're looking for a good, very stylistic adventure game, this is definitely one to check out. You guys know that I've already played Grim Fandango Life for you guys, and the Monkey Island series, as well as the Telltale series. This is like, it's kind of like Grim Fandango, except for just way more highly stylized, and it's actually really, really good. All right, guys, leave a like, leave a comment, let me know your thoughts on the game, and as always, catch you next time.
That's me. Okay, come on.